If you leave a carcass in the wild and set up a camera trap, you can monitor the different scavenger species that come to feed on it. By repeating this sufficient times, you will be able to identify all the scavenger species that live in a certain area, which is what scientists call species richness. Seems pretty easy, right? But then a more intriguing question arises. Why are there many scavengers in some areas and few in others? Understanding the distribution of biodiversity across the planet Earth is still one of the most challenging biological questions. Although the distribution of a species depends on several interacting factors, many studies support that climatic conditions are the main drivers of the latitudinal distribution of species. Overall, these studies suggest that species richness is greater in the tropics and decreases toward the poles. However, despite decades of research, a general scientific consensus on this topic has not yet emerged. But something the scientific community does agree with is that the current distribution studies must take into account the impacts derived from human activities. Our increasingly humanized world is facing multiple changes and impacts on species distribution globally. In the case of scavengers, we know that these activities may have positive and negative impacts at a local scale. On the one hand, traditional livestock farming practices, conservation programs, or feeding stations may benefit scavengers. On the other hand, habitat loss, poaching, or poisoning may reduce their populations. But what happens at a global scale? What is the relative contribution of climatic variables and human impacts to scavengers' distribution worldwide? To answer this question, our large research team compiled a comprehensive data set by setting up camera traps in front of some 2,500 carcasses in 43 study sites in 17 different countries across the five continents. Once all the scavenger species were identified for each study site, we also quantified several climatic variables related to rainfall and temperature, as well as the Human Footprint Index, an integrative measure of human impacts on the environment. We then analyzed how these factors affected the composition of the different scavenger communities. The statistical results left no doubt. The sites with less species were those with the highest human footprint index values, thus overriding climatic factors. Yes, humans have erased any natural pattern in scavenger distribution at a planetary scale. This diminished scavenger richness in highly human-impacted areas might have detrimental consequences, as scavengers are essential to maintain healthy ecosystems. Through accelerating the recycling of nutrients and removing potential sources of infectious diseases, scavengers play a key hygienic role in our environment. Our results add to the growing body of evidence that points to human activities as the main threat for nature conservation. Don't you think it's time to tread a lighter footprint?